In this video, I am going to explain anatomy of hip abductors. I am going to explain one by one. First muscle is this one. This is gluteus maximus. But wait a minute. Gluteus maximus is hip extensor and hip external rotator, right? If you divide fiber of this muscle to two parts, superior fiber does hip abduction. Gluteus maximus, superior fiber. Okay, this is very important to know. On the other hand, inferior fiber does hip adduction. Superior fiber, hip abduction. Inferior fiber, hip adduction. It's very important to know. Why? Because when you have tight hip adduction or hip abduction, maybe that tightness is from gluteus maximus. Okay? So, gluteus maximus is not only hip extensor, but it's also abduction and adduction. Let's go to a little bit deeper part. Okay, gluteus maximus is removed. Next muscle is this one. This is piriformis. This muscle also can do abduction. This muscle is part of deep lateral hip rotators. This muscle is the most superior part of deep lateral rotators. That means the function of piriformis is abduction. Simple enough, right? Next muscle is this one. This is gluteus medius. You see this muscle a lot in my videos. This is such an important muscle. I usually divide gluteus medius to two parts, anterior part and posterior part. Anterior part does hip flexion and internal rotation. Posterior part does extension and external rotation. However, think about the surface of gluteus medius. This muscle faces to lateral part, right? So, general function of gluteus medius is abduction. All parts of gluteus medius does abduction. Very important. And deep to gluteus medius, there is gluteus minimus. This is also important hip abductors. Okay, gluteus maximus, gluteus medius, and gluteus minimus, all these glutes muscles do hip abduction. Very important muscles, right? Then let's go to anterior part. Actually, anterior muscles also can do hip abduction. Okay, this is anterior view. Next muscle is this one. This is tensor fascia lata. Tensor fascia lata. This is an anterior part of hip, but part of this muscle is on lateral part as well. This muscle faces to lateral way, like gluteus medius and gluteus minimus. Thus, tensor fascia lata can do hip abduction. Next one is a little bit skeptic. When I was looking at my book to research hip abductor, one book says, this muscle also can do hip abduction. This is sartorius. I was like, no way, because sartorius is on anterior part of thigh. Main function is flexion. How come this muscle can do abduction? It's on anterior part. It's not on the lateral part. So here is my hypothesis. When hip joint is external rotated position, then sartorius faces to lateral way. This is neutral position. Then when hip is rotated to laterally, externally, then fiber of sartorius faces to lateral way, right? Now sartorius can act as hip abductor, right? This is my hypothesis because anatomy books said sartorius can do hip abduction. But I was like, that's a little bit weird. That's why I made this hypothesis. Same thing. Maybe rectus femoris can do hip abduction. Rectus femoris. In neutral position of hip joint, rectus femoris faces to anterior part. What happens when hip is rotated externally? Fiber of rectus femoris faces to laterally. Thus, that may do hip abduction. I tried this in my body myself. Yes, I feel rectus femoris and sartorius do hip abduction. This is my experience. So, rectus femoris and sartorius act as hip abductor depends on position of hip joint. I think this is quite interesting. In this video, I explained their location. It's very important to understand. If you liked today's video, please hit the like button, comment, and subscribe. See you next video.